अर्थ। ऑल लाइफ ऑन अर्थ इज डेवलप्ड इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ जिंक थ्रू नेचुरल एरोजन प्रोसेस। ए स्मॉल पार्ट ऑफ जिंक इन सॉइल रॉक्स एंड सेडिमेंट इज कॉन्स्टेंटली मूव्ड एंड ट्रांसपोर्टेड थ्रू द एनवायरनमेंट। इट इज एसेंशियल फॉर लाइफ, प्लेइंग एन इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन बायोलॉजिकल प्रोसेसेस ऑफ ऑल लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म, क्रूशियल फॉर सेल डिवीजन, प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस इन ह्यूमन बीइंग, इन प्लांट बीइंग, द इम्यून सिस्टम एंड द ग्रोथ। जिंक इज एसेंशियल मिनरल ऑफ एक्सेप्शनल बायोलॉजिकल एंड पब्लिक हेल्थ इंपॉर्टेंस, कंसिडर्ड ए लाइफ सेविंग कमोडिटी बाय द यूनाइटेड नेशंस। जिंक हैज वेरी क्रूशियल रोल इन इंजीनियरिंग, in sheltering zinc, in indispensable zinc. All the metal casting are extremely important in the global economy and are used in 90% of all finished manufacturing.
Sir, sorry to interrupt you. You have to resume your presentation. One of the participants has accidentally started sharing their screen. You have to resume your presentation.
Okay. शेयरिंग ऑप्शन फिर से जरा सोच कर देखो तो कहाँ से आएगा। किसी ने शेयर कर दिया, इसमें गड़बड़ा गया।
तो जहाँ पे स्टार्ट प्रेजेंटिंग ऑप्शन है वहाँ पे ही आ रहा होगा रिज्यूम प्रेजेंटेशन करके ऑप्शन।
हाँ हाँ यस आ गया। हैव यू गॉट इट?
जी सर प्लीज कंटिन्यू सर।
ओके सो काइंड ऑफ यू, थैंक यू वेरी मच।
थैंक यू।
सो द जिंक इज इन सेल्टरिंग इंडस्ट्री, ब्यूटी, लॉन्जिविटी, सस्टेनेबिलिटी। जिंक सीड्स हैज मेड इट पॉपुलर मटेरियल फॉर रूफिंग, वेल क्लैडिंग, ग्लटरिंग एंड डाउन स्पॉटिंग। Zinc dust and powders are indispensable raw material for the multitude of everyday products including battery, ceramics, cosmetics, glass, pharmaceuticals, plastic, rubber, paints, etc. Zinc oxide is an important has an important use that it has in Oats Association and website. Zinc in the environment, the concentration of zinc in natural without the additional influence of human activity is called natural background. The natural background level in surface water, soil, rocks vary over a wide range of concentration. Background levels of zinc in soil and rocks typically ranges between 10 to 300 milligrams per kilogram, and zinc in rivers varies from less than 10 microgram per liter to over 200 microgram. Zinc is an essential mineral in exceptional biological and public health importance, as is considered a life-saving commodity as decided by United Nations. Due to its unique property, zinc is used in wide range of consumer infrastructure, agriculture, and industrial products. More importantly, zinc is essential to life, playing an important role in biological process of all living beings, human, animal, plants. Zinc is crucial for cell division, protein synthesis, as it was stated earlier, and in immune system and the growth. Zinc in crops. Zinc is one of the 8 essential trace elements that plant needs for normal growth and reproduction. Nearly 10% of all protein in biological system need zinc for their function and structure. Plant requires zinc in a small but critical concentration for several key actions, including membrane function, photosynthesis, protein synthesis, phytohormone synthesis, for example, auxins, seedling, vigors, sugar formation, and defense against disease and abiotic stress factors. So, as for example, drought. So, it is very much clear that zinc plays a very important role in case of this crop, not a specific crop, rather entire crops. In India, among the nations with the most zinc deficient agriculture soils, and the average deficiency is projected to increase from the present level of 50% to an estimated 63% by 2025, because day to day we are going to be intensive and we are using the very, very exhaustive crops. So if the current trend continues, in some Indian states over 80% of soils are going to be zinc deficient. As Indian soil are zinc deficient, so are Indian people. The link between zinc deficiency soil and zinc deficiency in human, especially prevalent in developing nations such as India, that relate to cereal grains as the main source of calorie intake. 26% of the population in India is at risk for zinc deficiency, with India's current population of 1.2 billion. Now I can modify that 1.35 billion. That means that 312 million people in India are deficient, more than 312 million people in India are deficient in zinc. Around the globe, it is estimated that 50% of agricultural soil devoted to cereal cultivation are proteinly zinc, potentially zinc deficient. Over 2/3 of the rice grown worldwide is produced on flooded paddy soils, which generally contains very low amount of plant available zinc. Wheat is typically grown on alkaline calcareous soil with low organic matter in the semi-arid region of the world. The soils and climatic conditions tend to make zinc less available for uptake and use by the plant. The high prevalence of the zinc deficient soil in major agricultural zones severely limits agricultural productivity. Under zinc deficient soil conditions, plants show a high susceptibility to environmental stress factors such as drought, heat stress, and pathogenic infections, which in turn stimulates development of chlorosis and necrosis in the leaves and cause stunted growth. Applying zinc fertilizer to soil and onto the plant leaves offer a simple and highly effective solution to zinc deficiency problems and significantly reduce unnecessary loss of food production. It also enhances grain zinc concentration, which contributes to daily zinc intake of human population in a sustainable and environmentally responsible manner. The high prevalence of zinc deficient soil in major agricultural zones severely limits agricultural productivity. Zinc fertilizers can therefore make a significant contribution towards goal of higher crop yield in a sustainable and environmentally responsive manner. Simultaneously, zinc fertilizer can enhance grain zinc concentration and thus contribute greatly to daily zinc intake of human population. A study for the Food and Agricultural Organization by Shilappa found that zinc was the most commonly deficient micronutrient in the world. The study, which examined 190 field trials in 15 countries, found that zinc deficiency occurred in one out of every two trials. Zinc deficiency in food crops reduces yield capacity and lower the nutritional value of the crop. Zinc is one of the 8 trace elements that plant needs for the normal growth and reproduction. The 10% of all protein in biological system needs zinc for their function and structure. Plant requires zinc in a small but critical concentration for several key functions. Even when a plant's micronutrient of nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and water are met, zinc deficiency will prevent plants from reaching their full potential. In 2008, low manure application, high phosphate application, water logging, flooding of soil, example, rice paddy, high soil pH, example, calcareous soil, heavily limed soil, high salt concentration, salinity, low total zinc content in soil, that is sandy soil, high soil organic matter content, that is histophores, zinc inefficient crops variety, zinc deficient crop reduces yield, impaired quality. So today it is estimated that 50% agriculture soils devoted to cereal cultivation are potentially zinc deficient. Thus, soil and climatic condition tends to make zinc less available for uptake by use by plants. Under zinc deficient soil conditions, plants show a high susceptibility to environmental stress such as drought, heat stress, pathogenic infection, which stimulate development of chlorosis and necrosis on the leaves and causes stunted growth. One thing I would like to draw the attention of all our listeners and participants, that there is very, very toxic element, that is cadmium. This is one of the heavy element, just like mercury. So zinc reduces the cadmium accumulation of plants. Cadmium is a well-known metal that causes toxicity. It is very much toxic for human being. When accumulated a high concentration in body, cadmium may result in several health consequences, such as increase in risk of bone fracture, lung damage, kidney dysfunction, hypertension. In many countries, especially in Asia, it has been shown that dietary uptake of cadmium is a predominant route for human exposure to cadmium. There are several estimated indicators that rice originated cadmium intake is responsible for about 40 to 45% of total cadmium pollution in human population of some Asiatic country. In the US, about 20% of daily cadmium intake is derived from cereals. Rice, durum wheat, potato tuber may also accumulate greater amount of cadmium, leading to poor quality of harvested food and threatening of their export to other countries. So if we have to think, we are thinking for the export quality food grain, we have to avoid the cadmium toxicity. Increasing evidence is available showing that zinc significantly interferes with root uptake and transport of cadmium in plants. Zinc and cadmium are chemically very similar. Therefore, they compete for similar binding sites and transporter protein in plant cell. When plants are deficient in zinc or when growth media contains low plant available zinc, plants absorb and transport higher amount of cadmium. A number of reports are available showing that plants under zinc deficient soil conditions accumulate more cadmium in grain or other edible part. Soil and or foliar application of zinc therefore very helpful in reducing grain accumulation of cadmium. Data from Australia, Canada and Turkey show significant decreases in root absorption and grain concentration of cadmium after soil or foliar application of zinc fertilizer. One example, applying zinc sulfate into soil significantly reduces cadmium accumulation in flax seeds and durum wheat grain when zinc concentration was increasing. Food security exists when all people at all time have physical, social and economical access to sufficient, safe and nutritious food. Nutritional security means access by all people at all time to the adequate utilization and absorption of nutrients in food. In order to able to live a healthy and active life, zinc fertilizer contributes to food and nutritional security by providing a key micronutrient required for the growth and health of all plants, maintaining an optimal balance of available zinc for the plant growth, increasing yield to ensure food production, keeping pace with population, and yes, anybody? Any query? Okay. Increasing yield to ensure food production keeps pace with population and in income growth and hunger reduction. Maximum nutrient uptake of crop to address human zinc deficiency. Maximizing agricultural productivity without increasing land surface. Zinc deficiency is routinely corrected by soil or foliar application of zinc. For these purposes, we are using zinc sulfate as is the most widely applied inorganic source of zinc to soil or leaves due to its high solubility, low cost and availability in the market. The another one is it can be also applied to soil in the form of zinc oxide and zinc oxysulfate. The well-known organic compound of zinc fertilizer, which is slow releasing in nature, is EDTA, that is ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. However, due to its high cost, use of EDTA in practical agriculture is limited. However, again, I would like to add that if we will go for cost-effective way, then almost all are at par, because when we are applying this zinc sulfate at the rate of 10 kg per acre on an average, this zinc oxide at the rate of 6 kg per acre, we are applying this EDTA zinc at the rate of 4 kg only, because it is very, very slow releasing source of organic zinc. In addition, recent results show that in case of leaf spray, zinc sulfate is more effective than zinc EDTA even in terms of increasing grain zinc concentration. Rice plants in paddy field. Foliar application of zinc is used at the rate of 0.2% to 0.5% depending on the severity of zinc deficiency. This type of foliar application may be repeated 2 or 3 times over the crop's growth cycle depending on the severity of zinc deficiency in plant or demand and depending on the target level needed to increase grain zinc concentration for better human nutrition. Field trial with wheat showed that applying the foliar zinc spray twice in a rate of 0.5% zinc sulfate may increase grain zinc concentration by nearly 50% without any negative impact on grain yield where wheat plants are growing on a zinc deficient soils. Example of cost benefit of zinc fertilizer. Several published reports are available showing significant cost benefit effect of zinc fertilizer for resource poor farmers, especially in regions where soil zinc deficiency is of particular concern, such as India, Turkey, Pakistan, and China. Nearly 50% of Indian soils are zinc deficient. Analysis of about 2,50,000 soil samples and 25,000 plant samples collected in India indicated that approximately 50% of soil samples and 45% of the plant samples contain deficient level of soil, as reported by Singh 2007. According to Singh, 325,000 tons of zinc should be applied annually by 2025 in order to maintain the adequate zinc nutritional status of the crop plants in India. For human development, because the title is a plant as well as human, role of zinc in both dimension. So zinc is essential for all living things and plays a role in numerous aspects of cellular metabolism, as it was found in plants. It is required by catalytic activity of approximately 100 enzymes, and it plays a role in immune function, protein synthesis, wound healing, DNA synthesis, and cell division. Zinc also supports normal growth and development during pregnancy, childhood, and adolescence. A daily intake of zinc is required to maintain a steady state because the body has no specialized zinc storage system. Zinc deficiency is an enormous problem impacting an estimated 2 billion, I'm repeating, 2 billion people worldwide. Children under 5 years of age are affected, most suffering from retarded growth and development and high susceptibility to infectious diseases due to a poor performing immune system. An estimated 4,50,000 children between the age of 1 and 5 dies each year due to complications arising due to early childhood zinc deficiency, because whatever they are getting as their diet are highly deficient in zinc. Even in areas where zinc deficiency is uncommon, there are still groups at higher risk, such as elderly, pregnant, and lactating women, and vegetarians, among others. In addition to being a nutritional supplement, zinc is also considered a life-saving commodity by United Nations, as it was stated earlier also, and is the only promoted adjuvant treatment to oral rehydration salt, ORS, for childhood diarrhea episode. Everywhere you will find on wall painting that please add zinc with this ORS. So diarrhea remains a leading cause of death globally among children under 5 years of age, accounting for 9% of child mortality, second only to pneumonia. Zinc plus ORS is proven to reduce the duration and severity of diarrhea and to prevent subsequent episodes. In addition to being effective and safe, it is also inexpensive and has been touted as one of the best buys in child health. The World Health Organization, UNICEF, and others have a strong outreach programs aimed especially at including zinc on national essential medicine list and incorporating zinc as part of the routine public sector care offered to children with diarrhea. The effect of zinc deficiency in human is widely varied, since zinc is an essential micronutrient for every living organism. In humans, zinc deficiency can lead to stunted growth, poor immune system, and in children under 5, impaired physical and natural development, leading to decreased brain function that will remain into adulthood. The application of zinc fertilizer to soils and or crops offer a simple, effective solution to the problem of zinc deficiency in food production, animal health, and human health. For example, it has been estimated that enriched rice and wheat grains with zinc could save the life of 48,000 children per year in India. zinc deficiency has a direct relationship with health and the economic growth. Addressing it is estimated that in the next 50 years, farmer will have to produce more food and then was produced in the last 10,000 years combined. Because our population is going to be at a level of explosive manner. Most of this will have to come from increasing production on existing farmland requires continual improvement of today's farming techniques. As we all know that we cannot increase our land, so there is immense pressure on our land. This means higher crop yields, better economic and more sustainable land, air and water management and zinc fertilizer will be a major part of the solution to make this happen. Because as earlier stated, that zinc helps in withstanding the different environmental stress condition faced by our plant, and it is essential for the growth, development, flowering, fruiting, everything of the plants. The zinc industry through the Zinc Nutrient Initiative is partnering with farmers, agronomists, scientists and government to share knowledge, develop policy support and further innovation for zinc fertilizer to enable farmers around the world to grow more on their land and provide food and nutrition to all. Zinc for life. Why is zinc vital to health? This is a question. Among all the vitamins and minerals, zinc shows the greatest effect on our immune system. Zinc helps fight infection and can even reduce the duration and severity of the common cold. Zinc also enhances memory and thinking by interacting with other chemicals to send message to the sensory brain center. Zinc can also reduce fatigue and mood swings. Zinc is vital for taste and smell. It is needed for renewal of our skin cells, and it helps our hair and nails healthy. So, in all spheres, right from psychology to physiology, it is clear that zinc means life. Zinc is for life, and without zinc, no life. I think it is clear to all our participants. How much zinc do we need? This is a question, big question, that how much zinc we need. The daily recommended intake are 5 milligrams for intake, 10 milligrams for children, 12 milligrams for women, and 50 milligrams for men. Pregnant women and lactating mothers require more zinc to ensure optimal development of the fetus and the newborn baby. Nowadays, we are facing a severe challenge, global challenge, that is coronavirus. Zinc, as earlier it was stated, that zinc gives us resistance against cold, against smell, against taste. So zinc is essential micronutrient for human that serves numerous psychological roles throughout the body. As a result, recent reports concerning its consideration as a treatment for coronavirus disease 2019, COVID-19, are not surprising. Despite significant research describing now how zinc can efficiently impair the replication of a variety of RNA virus and growing anecdotal evidence of zinc efficiency for treating COVID-19 infection. There are currently no clinical trial result available at this time, but in future, as a combination, we are getting the recommendation that we should use zinc, we should use this vitamin C, we should use this vitamin D, vitamin E. So these are the recommendation by our physician, so that we can withstand the stress, we have more immune system against this COVID-19. International Zinc Association continues to monitor all primary research and ongoing clinical trials related to zinc benefits for the human health. This organization is crucial for all the zinc related activities and contribution of zinc and new ideas and new field of avenues where zinc can play its role. Zinc serves many metabolic functions, including the development and integrity of the respiratory epithelium, gastrointestinal tract, immune and nervous system, bone development, and numerous others. Relatedly, zinc deficiency resulting from insufficient zinc in the diet was initially shown to affect healthy growth and development in children nearly 60 years ago. As an indication of its importance, the World Health Organization now provides a recommendation of minimum daily level of zinc guidelines for fortifying staple foods with zinc and recommends zinc for treating acute diarrheal disease. In recent years, scientific research has also shown linkage between zinc metabolism and progression of condition affecting pulmonary and neurological symptoms, among others. What if we don't get enough zinc? This is a question which oftenly people ask. Zinc deficiency is a major global health problem. Lack of zinc ranks as the fifth leading risk. I am repeating, the fifth leading risk factor in causing disease, especially diarrhea and pneumonia in children, which can lead to high mortality rates. Zinc supplementation and fortification program could help overcome these problems as well as help growth among stunted children, another phenomena associated with severe zinc deficiency. So for life saving, without zinc, there is no life. As we have earlier seen that more than 1.2 billion people are not getting enough zinc in their diets. Zinc deficiency is a significant health problem in developing countries, especially among young children. Zinc deficiency weakens their immune system and leaves them vulnerable to conditions such as diarrhea, pneumonia, and malaria. The problem in numbers, if we would like to see 1.2 billion, the number of people worldwide who are not getting enough zinc, 527,000 number of children that the diet and annually from the diet annually from diarrhea, which is second only to pneumonia, and 200,000 number of child death that could be prevented with increasing access to zinc in coming future. So this is the importance of zinc. Again, how much zinc? Again, it is a repetition that daily diet for 5 milligram for infants, 10 milligram for children, 12 milligram for women, 15 milligram for men. Pregnant women and lactating mothers requires more zinc to ensure optimal development of the fetus and newborn baby. Without a doubt, the best way to ensure adequate zinc intake is to eat foods that are naturally rich in zinc, such as meat, fish, poultry, whole grain, and dairy. For many, however, access to any food, let alone nutritional meals, it is a lifelong challenge. While no country is without zinc deficiency, it is far more prevalent in food insecure countries in which people get most of their calorie intake from cereal grain. If grown in zinc deficient soil, the risk of zinc deficiency heightens. Dietary source of zinc and their average zinc content. Just so many food products are with zinc, but these are the most commonly used food that has been shown. The richest source of this zinc is oysters, 25 milligram, meat, red meat, 5.2, nuts, 3.0, poultry product, 1.5, egg, 1.3, milk product, 1.2, cereals, 1, and bread, 1. So here we are seeing that if we are a vegetarian, we have to be more conscious, because cereal, breads, milk, all have the zinc. Average zinc content is around 1 or 1.2. However, in case of these nuts, it is a bit higher, but in meat and oyster, it is very rich in this zinc. So zinc, this is the map showing the global. The darkened area are where the widespread deficiency, and the lighter portion shows the medium zinc deficiency. But there is no any area in the world where we can say that there is no zinc deficiency. And you can see in India, this is our India, Pakistan. So in India, the entire country is zinc deficient area. It comes under red zone, that is highly deficient zone, where zinc deficiency is very low. Zinc deficiency is very high. Sorry. Zinc role economy in today's world, population growth, urbanization, social and economic development, and even demand for on green economy are all contributing to an increase in demand for zinc. Within the metals and mining sector, zinc is relatively modest when compared to, say, steel, but the two metals are closely linked, especially in major market for construction, automotive applications, as zinc serves the critical role of protecting steel from corrosion. According to the World Corrosion Organization, the estimated cost of corrosion to all world economy is $2.2 trillion annually. This worldwide cost of corrosion is currently in the same order of magnitude as the cost to produce and distributed food worldwide. So zinc is contributing to food, and zinc is also contributing to our construction and steel industry. So zinc is the most vital element for all human being, for all its development and food activity. The difference is that the public is somewhat aware of the issue related to hunger and the cost of food, but totally unaware of the cost of corrosion today and its effect on sustainability of our infrastructure in the future. Today, over 50% of our zinc consumed each year for the purpose of reducing the cost of corrosion. Galvanizing, that is called galvanizing, zinc galvanizing. The role of zinc is energy and power sector is also well proven, that the renewable alternative fuel with implication of zinc and other metals, 25% reduction in primary energy demand realized in the 2040. Primary zinc was accompanied by 22% increase in the use of renewable energy sources. Hydro, wind and solar energy use the zinc. Similarly, I'm not going to narrate the things in on a larger scale, because these are minor issue for our concern, because we are dealing with the human and this plant related issues. But one should know that zinc is used in building also. Zinc is used in mobility, the transportation and infrastructure industry also requires a lot of zinc every year. This is the history. We are not concerned with history. This is the critical deficiency of rice leaf, and this is called the Khairat disease. And this is the zinc deficient corn. The stunted growth is visible, that how this plant, the internode space has been reduced, and the plant is stunted. So thank you very much for listening me. And now the seminar is open for all the audience. Please.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your information. And if any of the participants have any questions, they can ask now, or they can also put their questions in the chat box. I'll read out to us, sir. So this was a question from Nitin Pawar. In which vegetable fruit and zinc amount is high?
In all vegetables or in all cereals, zinc is not so much high. Only nuts, whether it is groundnut or other nuts are rich. Otherwise, the vegetables have, fruits have, they all have the zinc, but the quantity of zinc is very poor. That's why the most deficient people are vegetarians, because they are consuming a lot of cereals and a lot of vegetable and fruits.
Sir, there's another question from Siddhika Diwan. Is zinc consumption important for diabetic patients? And if so, what amount should be taken daily?
Already, the amount has been declared that the 15 gram for a male and 12 gram for the female. And zinc is very crucial for the diabetes patient also, because for the metabolic activity, for the synchronization of the metabolic activity, which is going to be impaired or which is going to be partially affected due to sugar, will be balanced by the zinc. So diabetic patients are in their diet, if they are not getting sufficient zinc, the physicians are recommending that they should have additional zinc as oral zinc through therapeutic use of the zinc. Yes.
Sir, excuse me.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Sir, my children are suggested to have a zincovit supplement, sir. They are having meals regularly. In spite of that, they are taking supplement also. Is there any impact if they have excess zinc in their diet daily? Will it cause any negative impact?
No, not at all. Because as earlier I have stated, that there is no system developed in our body to retain the zinc. There is no any point where zinc may be accumulated. Okay. So if we are getting something extra, that will go out. That will not be retained by body. Whatever body requires, it will have, but remaining part will go out. Yes.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Welcome.
Gurpreet Kaur, I think your question is already answered. Sir, Gurpreet is asking about the daily intake amount of zinc.
Daily amount of zinc, I have already narrated twice in my deliberation. That 5 gram, 8 gram, 10 gram, 12 gram and 15 gram. And for the lactating mother and pregnant ladies, that should be a bit higher, because they have to nurture the fetus as well as the child. Yes.
Sir, there's one question from Dr. Sarita Malik, ma'am. What are the natural sources of zinc in our daily diet?
In our daily diet, that should be by any means. By any means, it should be around 12 to 15 milligram. 12 to 15 milligram per day, it should be in our diet. So we have to see that whether our diet is rich or not rich. If you will like, then I would like to share again. Are you interested? Then again, I would like to share the slide, particularly the slide sir, related. Yes. Yes, I'm sharing the slide. Yes, see the two slides. This slide, oyster, meat, nut, poultry, egg, milk. If someone is interested, he may note it down. Okay. Oyster, meat, red meat, especially red meat, not poultry. Poultry birds, they have 1.5 only. Eggs, 1.3. Milk product, whatever, whether it is cheese or butter or what so may be, or milk, or curd, or paneer, it is 1.2. Cereals, average 1, and bread, 1. So this is the average zinc content. But nowadays, scientists are trying to grow and develop new fortified varieties of crops. Already, we have rice crop having 5 times more zinc. We have wheat crop, which is very rich in zinc. Again, we have maize, corn, which are fortified. It is also very rich, 4 to 5 times, even 6 times more zinc content. But these things will come up in mainstream. I think it will take at least 2 to 3 years. Then only it will be available in public domain. But the initial trial were very much successful, and now people are multiplying it, and on micro level it is in use by especially in those areas where highly zinc deficient peoples are in our country as well as in Latin American countries. And another one, the diet chart. Yes, this, how much zinc do we need? Recommended daily intake are 5 mg for infants, 10 milligram for children, 12 milligram for women, and 15 milligram for men. Pregnant women and lactating mother requires more zinc to ensure optimal development of the fetus and newly born. So I think both the points are clear. I hope so. I hope so. Is it?
Yes, it is perfect.
Sir, I have a question, sir.
Yes, yes.
Sir, some people use in the morning a copper glass or copper jug and fill the water, and he or she drink water to collect. Yes, sir.
Firstly, one should be very much clear that copper is something different metal and zinc is something different. Copper has also got very good influence on particularly killing the microbes. It has very good impact on killing the microbes. It reduces the microbial growth in its pot, in its jar, in its glasses. Microbial growth will be minimum, or no, better to say no, zero. Okay,
similarly, can we use a zinc coated means glass or zinc coated coated jug?
Our ancestors were having very great visionary. That's why they have developed the few alloy like brass. Okay, brass, you know, brass.
Yes, sir.
That was used for making vessels, pots, for kitchen utensils. Okay, so these were made up of this copper zinc combination, in different combination, zinc and copper combination. So these vessels were used by our ancestors. Today we are using stainless steel. Okay, so and stainless steel, so we are not getting even iron. Okay, but previously we are getting these things from our utensils also. Okay, so you can use better to go for this bronze glasses. Bronze glasses is better. Okay, that will give you dual purpose, that is copper and zinc both. Okay, rather going for a zinc glass, right? So I think
thank you, sir.
I think now a bit we have tried, and I have also tried to correlate the importance of zinc in human life as well as in plant life, as well as in social domain, as well as in our in totality, strength, vitality. Okay, I hope so. Tried to justify the topic of how much I was successful. I don't know. It's up to you. You have to decide that whether I was successful or not. But again, we have time. So I would like to have any query from anybody.
Sir, yes. There's one question from Jyotwa Kiran. If cadmium is more absorbed by plants than zinc, is there any side effect to our body when consumed?
Cadmium? Yes, of course. I've already shown that breakage of bones, cadmium is heavy metal and it is highly toxic. That's why the exportable commodities have been allowed only when it has very less quantity of this cadmium content. If it is loaded with cadmium, then it will be not allowed, because it is a health hazardous. So cadmium always one have to avoid, and particularly in our country, right from north to south, east to west, we have one common crop, that is paddy. Okay, so rice, everywhere rice, and rice is grown in muddy condition, in puddle field, in wetland condition, And in wetland condition, the absorption of cadmium is very high. So just to reduce it also and increase our productivity also, we need this zinc. So as a agronomist, as a farmer consultant, or as a scientist, whatsoever you may call me, I always advocate that whether you are using the zinc or not. I always ask my people that if you will consume lot of cereals, lot of vegetable, lot of everything, but your liver is not functioning properly, then the whatever you are getting, that will be digested but not assimilated. So digestion and assimilation both are different things. Similarly, plants are taking the nutrients, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, so many elements. But if their system is not efficient, it will not utilize. And if it will not utilize, it will be not able to reproduce the end product, that is, whether it is flour, whether it is fruit, whether it is cereal, whether it is pulses or wild seed, whatsoever we are producing. So in all cases, we require this zinc, because zinc is the key. It strikes the activity, because zinc is crucial for more than 100 enzymatic activity. And you know, enzymes are responsible for various activities. Even there is cell division, even there is root respiration, even there is a leaf movement, better to say leaf movement. During evening, leaves are shrinking, and during day hour, leaf are expanding. These are leaf movement. So these movements are also controlled by an enzyme. So unless there are enzyme, they will not function properly. There will be a paralyzed condition. So a paralyzed plant, you cannot expect a better result. So as human being become pale due to jaundice, better to say due to jaundice, human being become pale. Similarly, brown or pale color leaves are appear when zinc is not properly fed to the plant. And in older plants, not in younger plants, in older plants, in lower plants, these deficiencies are more significant. So we need fertigation to avoid the cadmium and to have a very good crop and to have a very healthy crop for our own health. Nowadays, even we are feeding the same byproduct from our feed, which is deficient in zinc. And the result is that our milk animal are giving us lower milk. Their fat percentage has reduced. Their conceiving percentage has reduced. Their whole per calf number of calves, per animal number of calves has reduced. Previously, it was more than 10. Nowadays, every 5 to 6, and in coming future, it may be 2 or 3 or even or less. So how we can support each other? Though the key factor is zinc. I'm not repeatedly zinc, because today we are attending the seminar or webinar on zinc. Whether it is seminar or webinar or not, but zinc will remain crucial for our life, for our vitality, and not for our life, rather entire environment, because if zinc is deficient, the plant will not stable, and if plant will not stable, our environment will be not stable. More biomass will be produced. More biomass production means more carbon fixation, means less greenhouse effect. So to all my respected participants, it's a message from my end that please use zinc, advocate zinc, and ask people for zinc. So zinc is a key factor for our life and vitality. Sir.
Thank you, sir. Sir, there's another question from Kavita Dua. Can we take zinc tablet, and how many days it can be taken?
Pardon. Again, please.
Can we take zinc tablets, and for how many days it can be taken?
It is a question very, very close to that somebody is asking me, somebody will ask such a type of question that how many days I should breathe? No. Is there any answer that how many times or how many days we should breathe? No. Zinc is a regular demand, just like oxygen. As we need daily protein, vitamin, mineral, carbohydrate, fat. Similarly, we require zinc, because in our body system also, zinc has so many roles. And the most important role that we Indian are known for our intellectuality. Our intelligentsia is worldwide proven, acclaimed by the global giants, that Indian are really very sharp. So the sharpness of the brain, it depends on zinc. So please, ensure zinc in your diet in a regular fashion, not up to how many days. It is not a medicine. So in medicine, we are recommending that please go for 5 to 6 days, then stop it. No. If you are using a balanced diet, which is rich in this zinc, okay, no need of any supplement. And if you think that you are not taking so much balanced diet, there is some deficiency, so one should go for the zinc. One should go for the zinc, for the supplemental zinc. Then only he or she may say that, yes, I am strong enough. Otherwise, aging will start. For the first thing, that your face will shrink and you will look like an old lad or lady. So if you want to be smart enough, please use zinc. Okay.
Thank you, sir. There are many questions, but they are repetitive questions which have been already covered by our today's speaker. So I will not be taking those. There's one question from Ranjita J. Naika. What are the symptoms of too much zinc in the body, if there's any?
Pardon, what is the question?
What are the symptoms of too much zinc in the body?
No. I'm again repeating that there is no system in our body. There is no system in our body where we can accumulate the zinc. Okay? So, firstly, a few products are which can supplement a higher degree of zinc to us, like oyster or red meat. Okay? And if we are using oyster and red meats, it is supposed that you have your own limitation, 100 gram to 250 gram, not more than that you are using. So in those cases, you are not going beyond the recommended dose of zinc, firstly. Secondly, if you are using the supplemental dose of zinc, that is Zincovit or whatever other sources, there are so many products in the market. So through that, there is a therapeutic use, and there is a recommendation that you have to use only one. So if you are going 3 or 4 Revital or zinc or anything, then it may react. Otherwise, if a normal uptake is there, there is no question arise that there will be any side effect. There will be side effect, but that will be positive with that. That you will be more fresh, you will be more energetic, you will feel more happy, your mood will be good, and you will give your best. So that will be the side effects. Yes.
Thank you, sir.
I think ma'am has got her answer. Any other participants, please, if you have anything.
If any of the participants have any more questions, please, you can turn on your mic and you can also post your questions in the chat box.
Sir,
yes.
I'm Dr. Pankaj.
Sir.
Hello. I'm Dr. Pankaj, sir.
Sir.
Sir, actually, I'm working on landfill treatment. Landfill treatment, waste land treatment and all this. I heard there is a lot of use of zinc. If I'm going to react with gases and all this, then there is very much use of this zinc in landfill treatment as well also, apart from body, human lives and others. So I want to know,
Yes.
Crop production and all these.
Yes.
We can use a lot of. That's why is it right, sir? I want to use that. That's why, in my patent and all these.
Pardon, pardon, pardon. Not clear to me. Can you write it?
पंकज सर आपकी आवाज क्लियर नहीं आ रही है, अगर आप क्वेश्चन नंबर पोस्ट कर सके तो मैं सर के लिए रीड आउट करूं।
सर मैं ये पूछ रहा हूं।
हां क्या पूछ रहे हैं? हां बोलिए।
मैं तो ये पूछ रहा था कि हमारा लैंडफिल ट्रीटमेंट होता है उसमें जिंक का बहुत बड़ा रोल अभी मैंने पढ़ा है, वो काम मैं अपने अपने रिसर्च वर्क में यूज करना चाहता हूँ फॉर द क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन एंड ऑल दिस। इज इट ट्रू और या इसको कैसे मैं यूटिलाइज करूँ जिससे हमारे क्रॉप का प्रोडक्शन बढ़े और लैंडफिल ट्रीटमेंट का?
आप उसमें क्या मोड आपने अपनाते हैं एप्लीकेशन का? व्हाट इज द मोड ऑफ एप्लीकेशन, वेदर इट इज फोलियर, वेदर इट इज सॉल्युबल फॉर्मेट और वेदर इट इज सॉलिड फॉर्मेट, कैसे यूज करते हैं?
हम सर इसको सॉल्युबल फॉर्मेट में लाते हैं सर, सॉल्युबल फॉर्मेट की बात कर रहे थे।
तो सॉल्युबल फॉर्मेट में करते तो कहीं कोई दिक्कत